Why, hello there. I decided to go ahead and do another part today. Why not? And the microphone was a little too close last time. I apologize. It seems to be resetting on its own. I'll try and keep it a... It was really close there. Keep it a little further away and see what happens. I haven't changed the video quality yet. I'm going to wait for feedback on that. But, yeah, let's go a little more.
I swear I didn't do it. I've got nothing to do with that business. I never killed nobody.
Oh, no? Then why did you run away when they came to question you?
Oh, good question.
I forgot to report to my parole officer.
Yeah.
I want to go back to prison. When I saw the cops, I just bolted. I wasn't thinking straight.
Surprise.
We checked out his statement. He has an alibi for at least three of the murders.
Fuck, that bastard was a perfect fit. Shit!
Maybe it's the origami killers. Not killer.
Ash? Okay.
Okay.
Sean Moss's mother's here.
Oh.
She'd like to speak with you.
I would just like to say that Ethan's a prick.
It was a few months back. The middle of the night. It was pouring down. Ethan came home completely drenched at about 3. I asked him where he'd been. He spoke about drowning the rain. He didn't make any sense. There was something.
Sometimes we're a little behind.
Something in his eyes. As if it wasn't really him. There may be no connection, but the next day there was that announcement about another victim of the origami killer. Find my son. I'm begging you.
Oh no, she's basically got Ethan fingered as the killer. Oh no. And he thinks he's the killer. Oh no, we're playing the origami killer. Oh no.
Norman Jaden of the FBI.
It can't be true, though.
According to our information, Ethan Mars is one of your patients. We'd like to ask you a few questions about him.
I'm sorry, that's impossible.
I beg your pardon?
I'm bound by an oath of secrecy. Under no circumstances may I discuss my patients.
Under no circumstances.
My job is to find Sean Mars alive, and I don't give a damn about any bullshit oath.
I know you don't want to protect a murderer. If you know anything, you must tell us, Doctor.
I'm sorry. I can't help
you. Yeah, technically they don't have to tell.
No, I must ask you to leave.
Doctor-patient confidentiality and stuff.
For your own sake.
Whoa, hang on there, Blake.
It's your duty to inform the police if you suspect one of your patients, Doctor.
Are you threatening me?
I'm just giving you some free advice, Doc. I suggest you take it.
We gotta move
Doctor,
him.
A child's life is at stake. You may know something that could help us save him.
I am going to call the police and make a complaint.
We're doing the whole good cop, bad cop thing.
Doctor, you are really pushing my buttons.
Whoa, Blake. Calm down, boy. So, I'm gonna beat him with a phone.
Boy, and tell me what I want to know, or I am really gonna lose my temper.
Let's get out of here.
Yeah, that's enough of you.
You have no right.
You gonna do beam with a phone? Seriously. Oh boy. Oh boy. Jeez.
Come on, Doc. There's an easy way and a hard way. It's your fucking choice.
Calm down, Blake. Good grief.
If you don't let go of this man immediately, I'll report you and you'll be off the case.
Yeah, seriously.
What the hell's the matter with you, Norman? What, you getting cold feet? You don't want to save Sean Mars anymore?
I want to save Sean
Mars.
We
have laws for a reason, yo.
But that doesn't give me all rights. So you're going to stop this shit right now.
And some laws are good, some laws are stupid. True.
Ethan Mars has had psychological problems since his first son died. Feels responsible for his death. Sort of morbid neurosis. He is haunted by visions of drowning bodies. A few weeks ago, After one of our usual sessions, I found this on the floor. It must have fallen out of his pocket.
Oh no! That's for realsies! And seriously, Blake, you did that in front of an FBI agent. What the fuck is wrong with you? Jay's like, oh,
Ash, I want you to assign every available man to finding
Ethan. Oh man, Barnes. Things are heating up.
I want a man outside his place day and night. Notify all agencies to start looking for him. I want you to keep an eye on the train stations, the airports, the bus terminals. I want every cop in the city on his ass, so that if he moves, we know about it. Yes, Ethan Mars is the origami killer.
We're playing the killer! Because Ethan's a weirdo and he has, oh, hello, Shelby. That was kind of sudden, like, yeah. What do we do next? Okay. That's what I thought. This is really early in the morning to be playing golf. I mean, it's not really golf, it's just a driving range, but still. Hello, I'm Scott Shelby. P.I. Super Guy.
I'm Lauren in the dark on this one. I'll pick her up from her place later on.
Don't worry, she'll ride a few dicks. Just completely forget all about it.
Golf club in town. Strange place for an appointment. I wonder what we're going to talk about.
Look at that guy. He's like, yeah. Stick,
little ball. Never could see the point of this game. Well, well. An old friend.
Oh, hey, aren't you the guy I beat up? Like, seriously, you're no bodyguard, man. Little fat middle-aged guy beat you up.
Thank you. Please come in, Mr. Shelby. Would you care for a coffee?
Oh, no, thanks.
Do you play?
I tried once.
No.
But I think the owner of the course is still looking for him.
It's an interesting sport. It requires strength, but also a cool head and absolute precision. Would you care to hit a few balls with me? There's no danger of damaging the greens here.
Okay.
Shelby might be on the wrong track here, since Mr. Ethan Mars is the origami killer. We're gonna play golf. Hit a few balls. You know, we're just like buddies. I'll take this stick here.
The balls are in that basket.
Oh, I'm going to be the best golfer.
The most important thing is to grip the club correctly. When you feel ready, you swing.
Is that what you tell all your bodyguards? Oh, I got a hole.
Impressive.
Yeah.
You seem to have a knack for it.
250 yards.
A beginner's luck.
I guess. I'm not meant to do this shit.
I'm assuming you didn't invite me here just to play golf, Mr. Kramer.
Well, no, fuckface, I didn't.
I hear you questions about my son.
That's right. I wonder if Gordy is linked to the origami killer case in any way.
Although it turns out he just might have something to do with it. Just might. Maybe. Like, literally maybe.
My son had nothing
that
to do with
that
shit.
Only 100, less than 100.
Well, then he has nothing to fear from my investigation.
Yeah.
You have no business investigating my son. I told you, he had nothing to do with it.
Are you sure there, buddy? This guy Shelby never gets the wrong man.
Kramer, it's up to me to decide who I want to investigate.
I'm an influential man, Mr. Sherlock.
It's rolling downhill. Well, not even 50 now. I don't think David Cage understands how this works.
Let's just say I'm trying to show you where your interest lies. How much do you want to leave my son alone?
Oh, really? Maybe he has something to do with it, then.
I don't play that game.
Nah. Shelby, don't play that.
Don't come near my son, Mr. Shelby. If you do, you'll regret it.
Have a nice day, Mr. Kramer.
Fucker. Nobody messes with Scott Shelby. P.I. Super Guy. That chick didn't even hit nothing. Eh. Oh well. Oh no, it's time to play Ethan. Jax is just... I hope I could just envision Jack right now, just rubbing his hands and going... They're going, oh boy, this is gonna be fun. This is gonna be the best part. Going into this busted ass building. This part's dumb. There's all these like
lizards. They look new, out of place with the rest of this old beat up stuff.
Man, just oh my gosh, just break the damn thing! Oh. I thought I could just break all of them. I don't know why I'm bothering. Break it! Yeah. There's a key hidden inside one of them. I forget which one. We'll just break everything. Yep, it's in there. What do you know? Don't need to break any more after that.
The pain's coming back. Drugs are beginning to wear off.
What drugs? We didn't take any.
Sean. 9711 Marble Street. It's the right place, but what am I supposed to do in this dump?
Yeah, it's not
good.
There's
a fire in here. Everything is all burned up. Still feeling weak. I can hardly stand.
What a baby. Just kidding. Things are about to get real, guys. Oh? Nothing in here, really. There's an iPad sort of thing. Suspicious. Oh boy, this one's fun. Some of you are going to be like, oh no, I don't want to watch this.
Are you prepared to suffer to save your son? You have 5 minutes to cut off the last section of one of your fingers in front of the camera.
Oh shit!
If you succeed, you will get your reward.
Wait, my finger? Oh shit! Oh no!
The pain's gonna be intense. Gotta find some way to reduce it.
Cut off a finger?
We got time, don't worry. Plenty of time.
I have to go through with it. I have no choice, for Sean's sake.
I have no choice.
This is nuts! I can't do it. I want to save Sean, but I refuse to do this.
You baby.
I can't cut off my own finger. I just can't do it.
I want to save Sean. I'd do anything. Anything but that. Gotta find a sharp object, something that'll make a clean cut. I don't want to have to start hacking away at it.
Yes! wish granted, Jack. Can I pick up one thing at a time? Yes, scissors. There's plenty of things you can do it with. There's a cleaver in the wall. There's a saw. Okay, whiskey. Whiskey will do it. We're gonna lay out all of our party favors.
I might just be able to get through this if I make the right choices. There's gotta be a way to do this.
Better splash you some cold water on there, boy. Oh,
I've got 5 minutes to cut off my finger. Gotta decide now. This could all go horribly wrong. I'm not going to save my son by dying here.
Piece of rebar. I don't think we need this if we have the whiskey, but... I'm going to turn this fire hazard of a stove on. Heat up the rebar. You can figure out why we need this. If we need it. We're making this super hot.
You have 4 minutes left.
Okay, now we set that down. What other party favors is there in here? There's the cleaver. Pretty sure there's a saw somewhere. Oh, there's the saw. And you can just leave. Wait, what's this? Oh, there's a fucking axe. I didn't know that was there. Oh, there's a hatchet. What's this? Oh, fucking pliers. That'd be interesting, but Jack requested scissors, and I've never seen scissors. So, what's in here? Disinfectant would be a good idea. Okay, everybody. It's time to have a party. Oh, man. Oh, yeah, you better chug that shit. This is gonna hurt, boy. How much of this can I drink? Drink to calm the nerves. How much of this can I drink? I'm gonna drink a few more times. I've got time. It's fine. Oh, that's it. Okay, I drank everything. Oh, cool. Now I'm seeing, like, double vision. Sweet. Okay, I just have more scissors. Oh, boy. Oh, I gotta do it soft. I can't believe we didn't do it with scissors. I'm not sure how this is gonna go. If it goes poorly, I'm grabbing the axe. I've never done it with the axe. Stay there breathing. You're doing this to calm yourself down. So you steady out. This might be as steady as we get, though. Oh no, we got even more steady. That's fine. Okay, try it. I can't believe we're gonna die this way. Oops.
You have that fucked up. 2 minutes and 30 seconds left.
It's fine. This is gonna be super hard. Okay, that's how we're gonna do it. Alright, one more in and out. Oh boy. Okie dokie. Here we go. I can't think anymore, can I? Oh, well. And... Jesus! Oh, that hurts! Oh, his face is going through the floor. I guess the scissors really do work. He's not liking it. Oh, he didn't even finish it. Jeez. That makes it worse. Yeah, look at it that way. Maybe the saw would have been worse. I thought there was going to be like safety scissors or something. Okay. I need a thing.
Under the desk.
Hard. Am I not allowed to use my other party favors? Am I not allowed to? It didn't give me the option to use that stuff. Excuse me. We're just gonna dive gangrene before this is all over at this rate. It's supposed to let you use disinfectant in the hot rebar. The rebar to, you know, cauterize the wound. You guys having a really fun time though, Sean. He's been swimming for a couple of days now. It's supposed to let me use a disinfectant in the rebar. Maybe it's not necessary with the scissors? I don't know why it wouldn't be. Oh well, whatever. There you go, Jack. You got your wish. Now she's going to find Ethan super dead. Man, I'm hungry. I should have popped food in the oven. Oh well. If I have to, you'd say her nostrils are pretty gray. What the hell? People can just hear sobbing inside.
Perfect. Nobody moves until I give the signal. Is that clear? We nail him as soon as he sets foot outside.
Right, Lieutenant.
Lucky that patrol spotted his car.
What's he doing in there?
Beats me. You're the profiler, right? I thought you were supposed to be right inside the killer's head.
Well, that's just it. What I know of Ethan Mars doesn't match the killer's psychological profile.
Oh, we got three people here, eh?
The jury's gonna choose between your theories and concrete proof. What's that girl doing there? Marsh comes out now, she's gonna be in trouble.
What do we do, Lieutenant? Wanna get her out?
No, stand down.
No, these chuckle fucks are just gonna sit there for a while. Now, this is timed, so. Yeah.
The police. They staked out the building where Ethan is.
Even in a time of crisis like this, she's still waggling her ass like that. Ridiculous.
She's going inside. Maybe she lives there.
Oh, come on.
Well, we don't want anyone hanging around if Mars comes out.
Ethan, what happened? The police. They're out there. I think they're here to arrest you.
Fuck.
We've got to find another way out.
My finger really hurts. I mean, what's left of it.
Shit. What's he up to in there?
No point in trying to get...
Wait for a go on my word.
I'll move this shit. Oh, wait, no, that leads back outside. I won't do that.
You've got to find another way.
I was looking at the wrong way.
You can't get out that way.
Why not? That's not the way I meant to go anyway.
Solution. There's got to be a solution.
Yeah, it's here. It's fine. But even if I don't find it, it's not the end of the world, really. Seriously. Look at that, just sitting there going,
The window's too high. I'll never manage to pull myself up.
Oh, come on.
Shit. It's too high.
I actually forget what you're supposed to do here. I guess I can move this.
Ready on my go. Stay here, Jaden.
Running out of time.
I'm coming with you.
Two men at the door, hold your positions. It's a go.
Hey, idiot. Get over here. I'm really trying to open it, guys.
Come on, let's go this way.
Come on, stupid. Up you go. Up and at 'em. See you, fuckers. Thick. Crazy.
Hey, you, don't move. I'll shoot.
Come on.
You ain't gonna do shit.
I can't.
Hands in the air.
Could be in a baby.
I better leave him and get the hell out of here.
Nah.
I might still manage to escape if I go now.
Woman. Shit.
Shit.
It's that girl
who spotted us.
Everybody
down there. We need to move while we still have a
chance. Follow them.
The subway.
Yeah.
We've got the cops on our ass. No way out. What the hell am I doing, helping a fugitive escape? I must be completely out of my mind. The subway entrance across the street. That's our only hope.
These controls are so bad.
Just have out of it. I'm dead weight. I won't be able to carry him for long. I can't give up now. There's still a chance we can get through this.
That was easy. Considering doing something, but eh.
Ethan, what's the matter? We've got to keep going.
I'm not going to do it.
Ethan, they're coming.
I was considering letting it get caught. There's an extra scene, but
the crowd. They might lose us in the crowd. Ethan's going downhill fast. He seems to be having trouble breathing. They're everywhere. They're trying to... The crowd. They might lose us...
Oh yeah, was this going somewhere else? I might get caught anyway.
They might lose us in the crowd. I'm so tired.
Don't move!
Oh, I've never seen that happen. Well, it looks like we're getting this extra scene anyway because I forgot where to go. It's like they're just barging into the corner and go... I honestly forgot where I was supposed to go. See, the way I've seen it, like, by the time they find him, like, she was long gone. See, we're still listening to Ethan breathing. But we're close to her. That's so weird. Well, I didn't really want to do the extra scene, but we got an extra scene with Jaden. Well, maybe I can just blaze through it. Whatever. See, Ethan's supposed to get away, but if you get caught...
I'm not here to judge you, Ethan. I'm trying to save the life of your son. We still have time, but it's running out. Help me, Ethan. Tell me what you know.
Kim McGill trip.
By my estimate, Sean has approximately 12 hours left to live. It's raining outside, Ethan. Each drop gets him closer to the end, a slow and painful death. Where is he, Ethan? Where is Sean?
I don't remember. I'm so pissed.
God damn it, Ethan! Where is Sean?
I don't know.
Look at these, Ethan.
I'm gonna be bad cop with them because Ethan kind of deserves it. Sometimes.
Lives taken. Drowned. In the goddamn rain. Recognize this one, huh? That's your son, Ethan. That's Sean.
Look at his
face. He is still alive. Talk to me, Ethan. Say something.
I don't know what I did. I see they bandaged you up.
But I can't remember what happened.
You're a crazy origami killer.
I don't know where he is. But the only way to find him...
Only way?
Is to let me out of here.
Get me out of here.
I'm the only person who can save him.
This is bogus, because you made your own damn trials.
It just doesn't add up, Ethan. Stop with this pathetic nonsense and tell me the fucking truth!
I love my son. I love my son.
That's why I threw him in a rain gutter.
If you keep me here, Sean is going to die.
Cut the camera. The bad stuff's about to happen.
Frankly,
I'm going to sit down and watch. Oh.
The only thing I want to know
I can't do that.
Is where you've hidden Sean.
I'm just going to lean against the wall.
No. I would already have saved him if I knew where he was.
We can't leave the room.
Okay. This is your last chance, Ethan. And this time, I suggest you think carefully before you answer. Where is Sean?
Let's let him get roughed up a little bit.
I don't know.
Come on, it's Blake. You know he's going to do it. Oh, we can't see much like this.
Wrong answer. I asked you a question.
If you beat him, his confession is worthless.
Whoops.
Now throw the case out.
What's the matter, huh?
Even if he is a killer, that doesn't give you the right to beat him.
Whose side are you on, Norman? Are you defending this piece of shit?
I'm defending the law, and the law says he is innocent until proven guilty.
This guy's got no rights, do you hear me? No rights at all!
Fuck you, Blake.
You fuck!
Beach.
Are you gonna tell me what I want to know or I'm gonna fucking cripple you?
Carter, stop. I'm gonna report you for this.
Go ahead! Get the hell out of here! I couldn't stand you from the very beginning, Norman! Now get the fuck out!
FBI is gonna come down on you, bitch. Just like your sister.
That bastard is gonna beat a confession out of Mars. He just wants a culprit, even if it's the wrong guy.
Yeah, this doesn't solve anything, even though it seems
that
pretty obvious.
That's the way it's gonna go. I'm gonna tell...
Blake is trying to beat a confession out of Ethan Mars. You've got to do something!
Which is more important, Norman? Finding little Sean Mars or sparing that lowlife a few bruises? You can't make omelets without breaking a few eggs.
Goddamn! Ethan Mars is innocent! We've got to get back to looking for Sean if we're to have any chance of finding him alive!
This case has worn you out, Norman. You need some time off to think it through.
Fuck you guys. Fuck everybody. No, don't take it. Even though I've already fucked up. I hate everybody. He's an airy world. You don't have to get this right. But if you get it right, he plays a little tune. During the next conversation. I thought this was keep playing. Oh well, whatever.
Your vodka, sir.
Thanks.
You look preoccupied, if you don't mind my saying so. Problems with the investigation?
Blake is convinced that Mars is the
killer. Wait, let's play it.
Not you. I thought there was some evidence to that effect.
That's true. But it just doesn't make sense. His psychological profile doesn't fit. Neither does the geolocalization. I can't see this father drowning 8 victims before kidnapping his own kid.
It does seem a little silly, doesn't it?
Mars is not the Aragami killer.
I don't know.
I'll stake my life on it.
Well, watch what you say.
And who is?
I haven't the faintest fucking idea.
Maybe you should review the evidence in your possession.
That's just what I was thinking of doing.
Now, this scene happens regardless.
One last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in you-know-what. It can be dangerous.
Yeah, no more trip to old boy.
I'm trying to keep a handle on it, but that's difficult. It gets more and more difficult.
It'll end up killing you if you're not careful. That would be most unfortunate, sir.
It would be most unfortunate. Yep, time to get some work done. I thought I had a different background.
Well, looks like there's something new.
Hey, I was picking my environment.
Near the park on the afternoon Sean Mars disappeared. I doubt there's anything on it, but you never know.
Well, yeah. Okay. Do you analyze this? No data.
A Chevrolet model corresponding to the tire prints passed at 1602 heading for the park, when in the opposite direction at 1637. That could fit the time that Sean Mars disappeared.
Oh.
Could it be the killer's car?
It could.
Pity we can't see the driver's face.
That'd make things a little too easy, wouldn't it?
A car was stolen. Let's see.
Owner Philip D. Campbell, eh?
Was suspected of stealing it, but the charges were dropped. Not enough evidence.
Jackson Neville, eh? I figured it was going to show his, well, where he's hanging out at. Oh, well. But we can look at this now. He's got nothing on him.
Jackson Neville, a.k.a. Mad Jack, involved in several cases of buying and selling stolen vehicles. Considered to be very dangerous. This guy might have provided the killer with a car.
He's the armed, an armed man.
That's all I have right now.
Well, that was a very quick session, actually. That's all you have to do. Now, that's the only thing you had to do. This is the other part of the scene you get if Ethan gets caught. Because guess what we gotta do?
I should consult my superiors. Maybe... No, that's stupid. I gotta handle this on my own. I gotta find some way to get Ethan Mars out of here. Even if there's only a 1 in 1,000 chance he's telling the truth,
did
he may
Mars
still
confess?
Be able to save his son.
No, not yet.
Oops.
Lost consciousness. We'll give him a break and then we'll get back to him.
He must be tough.
It's none of my business.
Thought.
If Perry and Blake think Mars is the killer, what
tough
can
or
I
not,
do about
he'll
it?
Crack. They all do.
My gut feeling is
in
that Mars
case,
is innocent and I gotta get him out of here.
Lieutenant. You've done a fine job. I've called a press conference.
He may be guilty.
Gonna kick
he's acting
off in
odd.
One
his
hour.
Statements
I
are all confused. And
quite
heck,
event.
He never said he wasn't the Origami Killer.
Don't you wanna wait till we actually got his confession?
No point. We've got him dead to rights. That's all the press wants to know.
That's not right, though. Or is
Ethan
it?
Ethan Mars is innocent. That shithead Perry doesn't give a damn if Blake beats up a witness or if Mars is innocent. All he wants is to be able to tell the press they've arrested the
yeah,
Origami
yeah.
Killer.
Make sure you turn off the camera. That would be bad. They're just dead.
I can't do anything for Mars. These are serious charges he's facing.
I forgot to go in there first.
I just don't believe he's guilty. Nothing about him matches the killer's profile.
The killer? Officer, is this man dead?
Has he confessed?
Not yet.
I see. Leave us alone.
Lieutenant Blake said to...
Please. Leave us alone.
Yeah.
Right. I'll be at the door if you need anything.
I'm wondering what happens if you leave the camera on. I imagine you get bitched out pretty hard.
Christ. Are you alright, Ethan?
Are you dead? Ethan's having a rough couple days. It's even worse if it's just all one day. Get up, stupid.
I gotta get out of here. I've gotta save my son.
Let's see what I can do.
Huh.
Should be able to get him out of here without being noticed. Shit! What am I doing? Helping a suspect to escape? That'll cost me my badge and earn me a 10-year stretch. I'm gonna find a way to get you out of here, Ethan. Stay put. I'll be back.
I'll be right back, buddy. Now we go in here.
Gary, you can take a break. I'll keep an eye on him.
You sure? Actually, I was busting for a piss. If you need to adjust his handcuffs, the keys are on my desk.
Oh, yeah. I gotta grab that, too. I need this.
First, get rid of the cuffs.
Let's see, is this your desk? Yep. Give me that. My keys. Sup, bitch? You have no idea what I'm about to do. There's nothing else to do here. I mean, I can go take a piss, but that's about it. I should go piss and not wash my hands and just rub my hands all over Ethan.
That's it. You're free.
Don't say thanks or anything.
Here,
fuckhead.
They're having a break. If you're quick, you'll be able to slip out without being noticed. Head straight to the exit. Don't stop, don't talk, don't even think. Just walk.
Yeah. And, stay along the wall that's farthest away from Blake. Blake might not take this too well. You're gonna regret it. This is so... And he walks right past Blake! He could stay along the far wall. Close to where we are, but no, he's retarded. Then again, he did tell him to not think. And Ethan's like, oh boy, I can go on more adventures now. I guess we have enough time for one more.
Less than an hour ago, we heard from the police who have identified the man thought to be the Origami Killer.
The Origami.
Father of the kidnapped victim, Sean Mars, is on the run and should be considered armed and dangerous.
A police. You should be on the lookout for your son, but you're like, I don't watch TV.
Soon be able to announce the apprehension of this dangerous lunatic.
Fuck your TV, you don't know shit. Hey, I bought groceries.
I brought some food. I didn't know what you liked, so I brought some of everything. I hope that's okay.
Why are you helping me, Madison? You know nothing about me.
You're a creepy stalker.
You could have been killed.
I don't know. I guess it just seemed like the right thing to do at the time. You needed help. I helped you.
Good grief, your ass really stands out.
The news reports, Ethan. Every cop in the country will be hunting you. They say you're the Origami Killer. Is it true?
I hope so. That'd be super cool. Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know. But I'm the only one who can save Sean. For your own safety, Madison, I think you should go.
Go? Ethan, they're after me too. They've seen my face. I'm in this too deep to stop now.
You should have really thought about that before. Like, seriously, this was a really poor idea.
I sometimes have these blackouts.
Time to open
times
up!
Where I don't know what I'm doing. As if I'm someone completely different. The only thing I remember afterwards is the bodies. The bodies in the water.
Why are you hurt, Ethan? Why were you
hurt? Because I'm a klutz. You have no idea.
Is testing me, testing my love for Sean. He wants to know if I love my son enough to save him.
Ethan has multiple personality disorder.
He knows where Sean is. But the only way to find him is to go through these trials.
Why can't you tell that to the police?
And tell them what?
They're not gonna believe him.
Schizophrenic who drowned his victims and has kidnapped his own son?
Actually, they might believe that bit.
I have to stay free to save Sean. I have no choice. I'm his only chance. When Sean is out of danger, I'll turn myself in, but not until then.
You can't keep going like this. You're destroying yourself, Ethan.
Finding Sean is the only thing that matters.
There has to be another way.
Well,
you don't understand. Time is running out. Sean will be dead in a few hours. I have no choice.
I have no choice. Excuse me. Now take note of what he said. Please, there. Madison, I've only got a few hours.
Leave. Forget everything that's
remember happened. That for later.
Anything more you can do for me. If you want to help me, leave. Leave me to do this on my own.
Let me see a little bit of that butt. This is stupid here. I think. No, maybe that wasn't the right part. Never mind.
I don't have much time. I've got to find my son before it's too late.
Taking anything out of the thing.
I have to open another origami figure.
Oh, hurry up, he'll make me feel better. Holding it with my gangrenous hand. Feels so good.
I'll find you, Sean. I swear I'll find you.
Not even gonna watch. Ethan, you're filthy. Alright. I didn't even flush either. Tired of shit. What's this one? It's a shark. Are you prepared to kill someone to save your son? Brad Silver, 6784 Longway Road, Lexington. Kill him. Send a picture. Get your reward. Big money! Big prizes! Ethan's packing. Enough for one more part, I suppose. Might record a little bit of something else. As part of my, random bits of recording I think I want to do. I'll have to plug in a special controller for this. Okay. This is really stupid. Well, okay. It's not gonna seem stupid. For a bit, anyway. I want you to pay very close attention to this scene and remember it for later.
Manfred! Manfred! Anybody home?
Nope, everybody's dead.
What was that meeting with Charles Kramer at the golf club really about? Why is he so worried about me investigating his son? Nothing much
suspicious.
Just the dust in the clock's ticking on and on.
He couldn't hear shit,
it was
old man.
It's crazy to let her come with him. He's trying to help out, but she just gets in the way. I'll have to
unless she's whoring about.
Hi there, Manfred.
Hey there, fella.
Who is it? Scott. Scott Shelby. Do you remember me?
Hey.
Scott? This is Scott. Oh, yeah, of course. Well, good to see you. How long has it been?
Oh, about 10 years, I guess.
Oh, at my age, time means nothing anymore.
Oh.
I
kind of feel that way too, though.
But I try to forget about time.
See, they had to point that out.
How about you? Are you still with the police?
Oh, no, I quit. I'm a private investigator now. This is Lauren. She's a friend.
Hello.
Oh, hello,
young lady.
This is my personal whore. She follows me wherever I go.
This calls for a celebration. I've just the thing. Wait there. I'm sure I saw a bottle of scotch around here somewhere.
I keep a bottle of scotch in my workshop.
Nice to see Manfred again. Just like old times.
Oh, fucking fuck.
Do an old man a favor, would you, Scott? Tell him to call back this afternoon.
Sure.
Now, the part just after this, I know I'm going to fuck up. Wait, where is it? Is that on the counter here? No, it's over. Hang on, I'm working on it.
Hello? Yeah, this is Manfred's. He's not available right now. Could you call back later this afternoon? Thanks.
Well then. Are we gonna have a drink? Let's have a drink.
Well, to old friends.
Bottoms up. I'm gonna drink some more.
Do you like it?
Yes, it's beautiful.
It's beautiful.
It's a stradelli. Crafted in Venice in the 18th century. It's one of my favorite pieces.
Kinda neat.
Tell me, Scott, what brings you back after all these years?
I'd like you to have a look at an envelope. I thought maybe you could tell me about the typewriter that was used to type the address on it.
Well, I just whip this out here.
Let's have a look.
It is getting too bright outside.
Could you pass me the magnifying glass from behind the counter?
Oh, sure,
please?
I'll get it.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
My eyes are beginning to fail me.
Give me that. Need. There's your stupid magnifying glass.
Thanks. Well, let's see what this envelope has to say for itself. The Royal Five. Yes, the shape of the T's and the F's is typical of that model. Produced between 1907 and 1924.
That's old ass.
No doubt about it. It's a Royal Five.
Neat.
These typewriters, are they rare?
No, they're fairly common. I'd say many folks have one gathering dust in an attic or in their cellar.
I need a cellar to check.
Are there many places around that could repair one of these?
I bought the company's entire stock as spare parts for a song in 64. Well, they were going to take them to the dumpster, so I got the lot.
Hey, Danny.
You know, anybody around here who has one that actually works has been to see me at one time or another.
Sweet.
Do you keep a record of all your clients?
Oh, yes, indeed. At least the ones who pay.
Any chance I could get a peek at that?
Just a peek.
Yes, of course. I keep my account books in the office. If you're not in a hurry, I have a list of all the clients who ever bought a Royal Five or had one repaired.
Yeah, that would really help us out.
Yeah.
Delighted to help. Give me 2 minutes, and I'll be right back with the list.
Okie dokie. And now we're just kind of waiting for me.
If he has a 1920s typewriter, he may have needed Manfred's services to get it fixed. We'll know when we get the list.
She really likes that music box. Makes a really weird face at it. Yep.
The killer's name might be in Manfred's papers. Lauren thinks she's about to find the killer. I'm afraid she's going to be disappointed.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, all we're really doing is narrowing down.
Manfred went into his office.
Oh, what Let's the take a look. Killer might be using as a typewriter. That's all. It's
been a while since Manfred went in.
Hello?
Manfred.
Hello? Your call is lost, sir. A police
Oh, no!
I need
Fuck!
Sir?
What the hell happened? Maybe we will find the killer soon. Oh, dear.
Oh, my God.
He's super dead.
Oh.
Fucking hell. We got out this window. What the hell? This typewriter is important business.
Oh my God.
I didn't do it.
What are you doing?
I'm calling the police.
The killer has already called the police. I think he wants us to be his scapegoats. We gotta get the hell out of here.
What do you mean? Yeah. We have nothing to do with his death. We were just here when it happened.
Look, we're running out of time to find Sean Mars. The last thing we need is 24 hours in a police station explaining this whole thing.
Well, so what do we do?
Hide the evidence.
Watch the front door. I'll get rid of our fingerprints from everything we touched since we came in. You better work fast. The police are going to be here.
Yeah, you got to remember everything you did. It's not the end of the world if you don't.
What are you doing, Lauren? If someone comes in, we're going to be in trouble.
These are Manfred's account books. He must have been looking for owners of Royals when he was killed.
Forget it. We got to get out of here fast.
Okay, whatever.
Where did we leave Prince? Gotta remember.
On here.
Fast.
Okay. Over here on the... Wait, where is it? Where's the phone? Oh, there it is. On the phone.
Don't forget to clean Lauren's prints, too. Don't want her to be mixed up in this.
Where all has she been? The phone. I'm sure I'm going to forget some, but... Oh, well.
Poor old man. He didn't deserve to go like that.
The glasses. Don't have to do all of them, but I'm gonna. Well, okay. I'm gonna do them all anyway. Just in case I forgot which one's mine. Now you're just holding it with the other hand. This is. Okay. That makes more sense. Nope, not much.
Any second.
I'm almost finished.
All these bad controls. The music box.
I'm running out of time. Gotta move faster.
And the door.
That's it. We're done.
You get all the prints?
Think so.
I got what I got. It should be enough to prevent them from finding us. Come on, let's go.
I forget what line he says if he got them all. or missed one. So we might have missed one. Ah, I missed one. What was it?
So, you claim the victim was killed while you were in his shop, correct?
Yes, he went to get something in his office.
A few what minutes I miss? Later,
I went in to see if he was okay. That's when I found him.
I mean, again, it doesn't really mean anything, but...
You should have called the police immediately, Mr. Shelby. Would have saved us dragging your ass down here.
Listen, we had nothing to do with his murder. We were only there by coincidence. I just wanted to spare myself a few hours declaring I didn't see anything to a police officer.
P.I. or not, Mr. Shelby, don't leave town. And if you end up next door to any more dead bodies, remember to call us. Okay?
Yeah, whatever. What did I miss?
Well, well, Scott Shelby. You in trouble again?
Oh, hey, him and Blake are buddies.
Long time, wrong kinda. Place. You know what it's like.
Don't sweat it. I'll take care of it. For old time's sake.
Thanks, Carter. I owe you one.
Yeah. You want Look at him just lumber.
Well, I got some ideas. Nothing concrete.
Well, if it goes beyond the idea stage, you'd tell me about it, wouldn't you, Scott?
Sure.
Yeah. Fuck you, Blake. I don't know, some sort of animosity.
Where are we going?
I'm taking you home. This is getting way too dangerous.
No way. We're partners, remember? We had a deal.
Just how,
This isn't a game, Lauren. Manfred was murdered because...
How most of the windshield was wiped, but the blade was nowhere near long enough. No. I don't make any sense.
I can't take a chance on the killer getting that close to you again.
I'm not a child. I know what I have to do. I want to find my son's killer. You're not going to stop me.
Bitch. Oh, I'll be cold.
Well, then you can find him without me. I refuse to be responsible for anything that goes wrong.
Stop the car.
What?
The blades aren't long enough.
Car.
That's such a... Oh, jeez. I forgot I had to do that. Crazy bitch. Eh. Jesus, lady.
If you're not gonna help me find the bastard who killed my Johnny, I'll do it on my own.
That annoys me. I never noticed that before.
It's all my fault. I should never have let her come with me.
Mm-hmm.
Crap, I have no choice. I guess I'm doing this to protect her. Such an idiot. I better catch up with her. I can't just leave her like that.
She sure can't
find the guy who killed her son.
Anything, eh?
This girl's stubborn as a mule. She doesn't let up, with or without me.
I guess I gotta go fetch my pet whore. Hello. How you doing?
I miss him. I miss him so much. I'd do anything to hold him once again in my arms.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have talked to you like that. It's just that I wouldn't want to see you get hurt.
Now get back in this car. We're driving straight home. Oh boy, it's Ethan time. But what do we gotta do this time? We need a gun. We're apparently supposed to go kill somebody. Man, it's getting incredibly bright in here. It's just as well that this part is over. It's went on longer than I thought it would. Oh, and this is where we stop, everybody. Thanks for watching. More to come either Saturday morning or next Tuesday morning. We'll see. At least one video a week. And, yeah. Anyway, take it easy, guys.